did you get your receipts in there?
Yes. I sent them both. So I had to... So it was ended up being like 61 because I had to actually get the domain not from Wix.
Oh, really?
So I had to go through two different services, and then I still have some stuff to work out, but money-wise, the receipts are sent in. But technical-wise, there's still some stuff that needs to be worked out. So
it's looking great. So
what the hell is this thing?
It's meant to hold like an iPad mini.
Oh, okay.
And I don't have one of those.
Ah.
But I do have
you do have a bracelet.
Yes.
Well, that works.
I mean, nice. This setup...
Hey, man, whatever works.
I think this setup will work. What I was testing in the officer meeting, that won't work.
Really?
And I was too far back the first meeting, so I think this will work a little bit better.
Yeah, that looks pretty decent.
So...
Good stuff. Now you're getting food?
Greasy fingers. So
yeah,
I don't think this is straight.
I literally just thought. Yeah, greasy keyboard.
And this isn't my computer, so that's another reason.
Fair point.
You're not in the camera.
Sorry, Jesse and Brayden are just going. Oh, yeah. Next week, I'll sit by you, maybe. I'm going to have a dog next week. I'm going to be sitting by you.
Thank you. anti-distraction message, and I'm a distractor. So anyway, I know that the volunteer form is going around, so some of you have already signed up, but if you can raise your hand, if you want to be one of my seven people. And I think we probably have some of the room that have done this before.
Something on that for those of you who travel. So if you're going to St. Louis in a few weeks, or you're in case competitions, or you went to the IMA Beta Alpha Psi meetings, that's in thanks to BKD, because they're very generous supporters of the Romaine College District.
Okay, a little, our mission statement. Mission of BKD is to always strive for excellence in providing services to clients, create rewarding career opportunities, and maintain professional business and financial standards. So typically our clients are closely held businesses, publicly traded companies, governmental entities, not-for-profit organizations, and other individuals. Total personnel. We have 2,650 associates and 298 partners principals. Revenues were right at $600 million this year. We have a strive to be a $1 billion firm within the next 5 years, I believe. So that has been growing every year. Yeah, and so we have 38 offices in 17 different states. Here's all of our offices. Our most recent one is in New York City. So yeah, we're kind of all across the U.S. Now, our different industries, I'll kind of plug this towards like the Evansville office. We're not so much into healthcare. We do healthcare, but we're much more in manufacturing and distribution. Obviously, this kind of area is kind of a hub for N&D clients. So we do a lot of N&D. We do quite a bit of financial services. A lot of smaller banks. We also do SEC banks. Typically, I kind of focus on financial services, so I work mainly in financial services and commercial real estate. Not-for-profit and governmental, different private client services. We have a very large individual client base in our Evansville office. We do quite a few 1040s, especially in comparison to other BKD office. We're pretty heavy in the 1040s. Construction and
I wasn't scanning files all day long, all the busy season. I was actually in doing 1040s, doing business returns. I was actually doing business returns up until the 315 deadline. So we really strive to include you as a staff, even though you may be an intern. And we really give you the responsibility. We're not handing you stuff where they have one W-2. I mean, like, they have some their own real estate, so they have a couple houses maybe downtown or in the suburbs that they're renting. I mean, like, we're giving you some stuff that it's more than just a W-2. And right now, we're about to go and planning into our tax season for next year, and I'm going to pretty much hope, and Lauren can back me up on this, we're going to try and get all the experience that I can get, all the different industries. So choose your personalized career path. I mean, you could do more with Lauren's doing, like financial services, where you're doing banks, and then you can go into construction, real estate, manufacturing. I mean, there's no really limit to where you can go.
I will say that's kind of one good thing about BKD's size. We're kind of right in that middle market where we don't do, I mean, we do have super very large clients, but typically at BKD, you would not be given one client, and that's the only client that you work on all year. It's definitely not like that. You'll work in a lot of different clients, a lot of different industries, a lot of different types of clients. I mean, my first year, I did C-Corps, S-Corps, partnerships. I even did a couple of trust returns. I don't know how those got in there, but I did those my first year as well. And 1040. So a little bit about our SKY initiative. Our SKY initiative is kind of our diversity initiative. Right now, it's kind of focused on keeping women in public accounting. We kind of noticed where in that kind of manager type level in public accounting, we were losing a lot of our really good female staff. So we put out this initiative in order to keep women in public accounting, and there's been a lot of really good stuff that came out of it. Everybody kind of put in their 2 cents on what kind of they wanted to change, and one of those things was paid maternity leave, and so then they implemented it the year after. So there's definitely some really good things that truly do come from it. And then for SKY Initiative, we do different types of education training, equality training, empowerment, and obviously execution. So what does everyone think that some workplace distractions could be?
Cell phones.
Definitely. Social media, email.
Skype? Yes.
Or it's a physical service. So yeah, we already named some of these. Phone, social media, email, different web browsing, coworkers, environment, all kinds of different personalized stuff. So with the phone, typically what I try to do is not leave it on my desk. I don't leave it like exactly right where I can grab it, because then you tend to just pick it up a lot.
I take it out of my pocket and hide it away, because I mean, if you're at work and you feel the buzz, you're going to be right into return, you're going to be like, was that my best friend? I guess I need something. I mean, so I actually, I know I'm on. I put it in my, we have like a little cabinet that we have right next to our desk. I put it there and I don't check it until the end of the day. But, I mean, you could pull it out during lunch, you could, you know, like maybe every 2 hours or something, just check it to make sure. Social media, like, it's sort of tough when you're making that transition from college to the workplace. I mean, you're always connected to Facebook on your phone, Instagram, whatnot. We really try and to promote not getting on to any of the social media while we're at work, unless, you know, it's 4 o'clock and there's absolutely nothing going on, then you're probably okay to look at it. But I mean, we really try, you're there for work, you're focused on it, and you're really trying to help out everyone around you.
Instant messaging. So and get it answered. And a lot of times on IM, like if I have a long question or I'm having a problem with something, I'll just get up and go in that person's office and ask them.
So for email, it's common for where when you come to the workforce, your Outlook is already set up to where it shows a message on the bottom right or left on your screen. You get a ding. I actually got advice to turn all that off, so I don't even know when I'm getting email. And then I check it maybe like at the top of the hour, bottom of the hour. So like whenever you're in a return or something and you see that message, I mean, it's just like a phone. You want to go see what it is. Demanding. So really just select certain times of the day. Up here mentions productivity. Maybe say emails when you're least productive, because when you're in a return, you don't know what you're doing because you're so not focused. Maybe you can save your email for that time of the day and get that knocked out.
I also use the flags on my email. I don't know if you guys use those. I use the flags a lot. So if something pops up that I know I need to address later, but like I don't have time to look at it right now, I just hit the flag and then it pops up on kind of my right hand, like little toolbar that I go back to. Coworkers. Okay, so a little bit about the Evansville BKD office. We kind of do have like an open kind of concept office. We don't have cubes. We have a lot like what you're sitting at right now, kind of like long tables. We have small dividers, but it definitely promotes a lot of inter-office chatter. I always have a to-do list. I typically like to do it the night before. So the day before, whenever I'm at work, kind of towards the end of the day, I usually write down like all of the things that I need to do that next day because I feel like it's fresh in my mind, you know, kind of that night before. And then whenever I come in the morning, I can kind of see everything that I think that I can get to and do that day.
For my end, this is one of my questions. I know we kind of just went over the email and IM, but mostly in our office, we lock it. Let's say you're working on a return and you're just like, oh, there's something I don't know. There's something. I mean, you don't want to go up every 2 minutes and ask your boss, hey, how do I do this or what's wrong? So maybe like make a list of all your questions, and then if you can't go any further, that's when you get up and ask them. Because if you're asking them every 2 minutes, they're going to not be happy with you. So it's just some advice.
Yeah, definitely keep a question list. So. Stay hydrated. We actually did we had like this health initiative, I think this last tax season, where we did like a water challenge. Do you know how much water you're supposed to drink in a day?
It's like
2 liters or something.
I thought it was like
it's crazy.
Half your body weight or something, or even more.
It's a lot. So anyway, all of us were like drinking all of this water, right? Because we were doing the water challenge. It really does make you feel better. I'm not gonna lie.
Yes.
You are. You feel better.
Sometimes when you're at work, you might have multiple things going on at once. Kind of go through it, even write it down. What's most important, which boss needs it quicker, or maybe their due date is, you know, Monday and you don't have to be doing it on Friday. So really just keep a list of what you need to do. But also, if someone sends you an email and says, hey, do you want to go to this lunch on December 12th, and you know, it's October
for you guys, I know we're 12th largest firm in the nation, which is awesome. But I mean, like, we get all the big tools that all these big companies get, but I mean, we're dealing with clients that are all around here. So it's like we're regional, but we are a national firm. So it's really neat to really engage with these clients around here. I mean, we have a client that builds like 1.5 miles long bridges. So it's amazing.
I know the majority of our clients are probably within an hour to an hour and a half drive from our office. Our auditors typically don't travel with them. We have some long distance clients, but most of our clients are right here in the Peninsula area. And also, if you have any questions on like CPA exam, Craig has been knocking it out. CPA exam, graduating, I mean, transitioning to work, public accounting, any of that.
We're your resource, so don't
be
shy.
Yeah.
In the tax department, how much like face-to-face client interaction do you get?
Quite a bit, actually. I know for some of our larger clients, I know for a lot of our financial institution clients, I typically go out to all of those clients and perform what we call the FAS 109 calc, but it's actually the income tax portion of the audit. Like, I complete the income tax portion. And so typically, I'll go to a client in the morning, kind of get all of the information that they've provided us and work through that calculation. And then by the end of the day, I'm typically sitting down with the president of the bank or the CFO of the bank and explaining to them kind of where they fall in the income tax.
I mean, even today, the 1.5 mile long bridge company that we were talking about, our partner and some of the staff we are actually sat with.
Yeah.
You mentioned the number of associates and partners you had. Wouldn't you like to explain the process of going from staff accountant to senior to manager to partner, how long that typically takes and what all is involved in going from one rank to another?
Sure. So I'm what's called a senior two. I know a lot of public accounting firms don't have a senior two. They go straight from senior to manager. But whenever you start, you come in as an associate, and then an associate typically takes 2 years, and we require you to pass your CPA exam in that time period, to which point you'll be promoted to senior. And then you'll be a senior associate for about a year, and then be a senior two. And then you'll be a senior two for roughly a year, year and a half, to manager. Now, typically over manager, once you get to senior manager level, to be promoted to a senior manager level, you have to sit before a board, and they decide. So it's kind of like, those are not as like hard 2 year, 1 year. You know, once you kind of get up there, it kind of can vary a lot based on office needs, based on the types of clients that you work on a lot of different variables. Typically we have partners that may partner in roughly 15 years. It could be more than that, it could be less than that, so, but right around there.
After manager, senior manager, and then there's a director.
Yeah. How many partners do you have in the Evansville office?
Right now, let me see. We've had some retire recently. We have, I believe, 4. We have 1 tax partner, 3 audit partners. We also have a title called managing director. And what a managing director is typically kind of a partner level person, but is not an equity partner. Yep.
Yeah. Which 3 parts did you pass the CPA?
FAR, DEC, and REG. I got audit level.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm getting FAR.
Yeah. I took that one first. I was like, if I don't get it, you know, then my timer doesn't start.
Offer like reimbursement for our checker or anything like that?
Yeah, we provide checker for grief. get a ton of competition for Big Four. So typically our, like, the clients that we like to kind of solicit is, you know, probably the $100 to $300 million in revenue range, right around there. So it would be like a small client for a Big Four, but it would be a size client for us.
We really try to do qualities that match ourselves, so we won't grab someone that's just like, oh, they got the biggest revenue in New York City. I mean, we're like trying to fit our culture with them, so we're doing it reasonably, and we're not just doing it just so we get, you know, higher on the rankings and make a bit more.
How difficult would it be to move from Evansville to Louisville or New York or Chicago or something like that?
Actually, not that difficult. We just had a girl in our tax department move from the Evansville office to St. Louis. So we had a girl transfer from our Bloomington office down to Evansville. We had a guy that interned with us several years ago, interned with us, really liked BKD and everything, really wanted to move to Dallas. So he moved to Dallas and they hired him on full time in Dallas. So it's something that happens fairly often.
And I just started and I already had something in my mailbox saying, do you want to work in New York City? So it's there. And our Nashville office is really growing. We just started doing that about 5 years ago.
Yeah, it was a pretty new office right when I started. So
you doing auto or tax?
Tax.
Tax. Did you say you worked with Ford too?
I did do an internship.
Which one?
KPMG.
What was it like?
It's definitely different. I mean, I can't speak for all KPMG offices, but I did state and local tax, which is the SALT. It's different. You're not doing compliance. So, I mean, we had a client come in and they said, hey, we have this product and we want to know whether it's taxable in your state. And so we had to, they divvied it up among offices and we had to look up and see whether that product was taxable in your state. So I looked at like Wisconsin, Texas, and you know, you're researching online and you got the resources to do it. And you send your results and, you know, they put it together. And this company, you know, you could save them millions and billions of dollars just by what you research. You could do it for all sorts of clients. I mean, it's just like maybe one and done thing. So like, hey, does this transaction, what's it going to come out to if we take an aggressive approach? Do you think we'll get sued for it? You know, stuff like that. There was four of us in state and local. There was going to be four. There was three. But I mean, for BKD, I just really connected with one client. And Indianapolis, it was cool. I mean, you know, you can go downtown. There's German restaurants in the corner. There's bars everywhere. There's Massachusetts Avenue. I mean, it's cool, but it's Evansville. Just really stuck together. I just felt peace. You know, just felt like it was the place to be.
They get more into SEC reporting as well because they tend to do the larger clients. And when you get outside the U.S. in some countries, like in Russia, I was meeting with a KPMG person. He actually had a franchise. So he said he was with KPMG, but it was just like a McDonald's franchise or something like that. He owned his own little office and then sent a percentage of it back to KPMG. So it's different. It's a different business model.
Yeah, and there was some compliance up there, but not a huge lot. Huge amount. A lot of the clients that KPMG would deal with, I mean, they're doing like specific questions or really tough stuff, like art, research and development credits. So like if you did tax, you wouldn't really be doing tax returns. There are exceptions, but a lot of those big companies, they have enough money and people that they hire their own and then they just do their return in-house. Can't speak for audit, but they're busy.
Any other questions?
Well, since we have information systems and finance students in here as well, they're not all accounting. Are there any opportunities at BKD for students that majored in information? Jeff, you mentioned earlier that, I mean, Jeff, what's your name?
Okay.
Sorry. You mentioned earlier that your dad, Jeff, had a Series 7 exam that he passed because they were doing financial consulting. Mm-hmm. Are you still involved in that as far as PKD providing financial consulting advice? Or?
Sure.
Okay.
Sure. That's on the PKD kind of wealth advisor side. There's a lot of certified financial planners there.
So they would have finance backgrounds?
Sure.
I mean, it's kind of, this is, I don't know about any other offices, but we have a partner, or no, he's a director. He deals with investment partnerships, so what happens is like these families, they have some money, and they want to make sure it gets distributed among their family members. So they all form a partnership, and then that partnership will have a lot of investments. So they'll work with us at BKD Wealth Advisors, and we'll invest it for them. And then, we do the tax return and then we'll dish it out EFK-1s to individuals.
We call them flips. They're family limited partnerships. Oh. But anyway, yeah, what's called, we just call them flips.
Sheets, where are those at right now? Okay, has everyone had a chance to get the sign-up sheets, sign up for community service opportunities, this sort of thing?
I don't need to look up.
Okay, so you want to send that way?
Also, if you haven't paid your dues, make sure to do that.
Yes, they were due last professional meeting, but we will accept it today and today only if you didn't get it in last meeting.
Remind me, I have some certificates I need to get to you that came from DOT, the global office.
From the what?
Global office, you know, the member certificate.
Oh, okay, yeah. Yeah, cool. Sounds good. Alright, well, in that case, unless anyone has any questions or anything, I think that's a wrap.
We also have business cards down here, so if you think about other questions and want to ask, grab a business card.
And BKD does their interviewing at the beginning of the fall semester. They do like the interviews out here.
Yeah.
So if you guys are interested in interning there, be sure to look for that next fall. All
right.
Cool.
Good stuff.
Thanks, guys. Oh, wait. Pizza. Thank you, man. Everybody grab a pizza form. So remember, five pizzas. Five pizzas. Those are due November 8th, so not this professional meeting, but the next.